Abel Ferrara has always been one of my favorite filmmakers ever since I was young and I first got into movies. I eagerly await whatever he does next because I know that it's going to be different. And I know it's going to have a strong message and more than likely it's going to be a very personal work. So last night, I finally got around to watching Abel Ferrara's 2020 film, Siberia, starring Willem Dafoe. Now, I'm watching the movie with my partner, and she turns around and says, "John, will you stop doing that?" I said, "Stop doing what?" She says, "That's the fourth time you've said this is an art film. You're starting to sound really pretentious." So I stopped and thought for a moment and I thought, why am I calling this an art film? Is it because I'm defending it? Now, Siberia contains a lot of things which would be connected with someone saying, "Oh, that's an art film." There's a lot of nudity, a lot of violence, a lot of beautiful cinematography, fantastic looking landscapes that could be oil paintings in themselves. So it contains everything that I guess one would put together with calling something an art film. And it reminded me of something that I read when I was a student. It was in a book about Ingmar Bergman, and it was an article that Jean-Luc Godard had written about Bergman's films Illicit Interlude or Summer Interlude and Summer with Monica. And what Godard had said is that there are a few films that you can say something like this about. But what Godard was referring to is saying something like, "This is the most wonderful of films about a film." And that one sentence, "This is the most wonderful," or "This is the most beautiful of films," is all you need to say about that movie. Because there's nothing else you can really say about it. And I think that's what I was going for when I was calling Siberia an art film. I think that's what I meant. So in calling it an art film, that was just my go-to response, but what I was meaning was, this is the most beautiful of films. Because it means something, and it touches something. It's a very personal work.
Your soul is outside of you, and you must claim it.
You destroyed my life.
It's a film about a guy looking back on his life, going through his dreams, literally in the film riding a dog sled through the snow or walking through a desert of your dreams, of your memories, and reflecting back on a life. In that way, it reminded me of Jack Kerouac, his famous, I think it was his last novel, Big Sur. And I'd read On the Road when I was a teenager and thought it was fantastic. But when I was in my late 20s, I read Big Sur and thought, this novel is much better. Why does everybody talk about On the Road when they should be talking about Big Sur? Big Sur is a novel about somebody looking back over his life and seeing this was all bullshit. And in a way, I think that's what Siberia is doing too. Not calling it bullshit, but looking back over a life and trying to make some sense of it. Ferrara is one of the most artistic of filmmakers, and I think that's why I go back to his work again and again. His latest films, Tommaso, Siberia, Pasolini, have all been works kind of about artists, and I think that's why I'm referring to them as art films. But Jean-Luc Godard put it more succinctly and much better than I can. He said you should see it like this. This is the most beautiful of films. You go to Siberia in the same way you would go to a gallery to look at a painting or listen to a song. You just absorb it. You don't try to explain it. It's an experience. There are very few movies I think you can say this about. And I started to reflect on movies that I've seen in my life that I think you could say this about. For example, Kelly Reinhardt, Night Moves, or Arthur Penn's Night Moves for that matter. Films like Basquiat by Julian Schnabel, the great film about the artist's life made by a friend of his. Dead Man by Jim Jarmusch. These are films which you go to and bring yourself to and take away from it kind of what you brought to it. So Abel Ferrara's movie Siberia, I think, is like this. It's a film you sit down and experience. And I think that is an art film. But to take Jean-Luc Godard's words, this is the most beautiful of films. Because it does what a film that someone's trying to make to give you an interpretation of life or an impression of life does. It gives you an experience. I guess I compare it to films like Julian Schnabel's Basquiat because these films have moments in them that are about experiencing life. For example, in Basquiat, the film is a fantastic film and you could pick many moments from it, but there's one in particular I remember. When Jeffrey Wright, portraying Jean-Michel Basquiat the artist, isn't doing anything spectacular, he's not painting or taking drugs or living the lavish lifestyle of an artist, he's riding a bike down the street after smoking a joint. And he looks up at the trees, and it's just a tree swinging in the breeze, and you experience a moment of life. In that moment, Basquiat is alive in that film, and it's a film about being alive. And that's what Siberia is like. It's a film that wants to give you the experience of being alive. Sometimes you just take in a deep breath and feel that cold, like the cold of Siberia, and know that you're alive. And I think Siberia is a film which Abel Ferrara is making about experiencing being alive. And while you watch this film, in that hour and a half, you're experiencing someone who's saying, "We're alive."
Tell me, Professor, what do you make of the black arts?
И он должен знать, что ты от него беременна. Определён.
There's also a great movie online, which is free to watch, which is a documentary that Abel Ferrara made while he was promoting Siberia, just as the COVID pandemic really hit. So it becomes a documentary about a lone figure moving through cities. But there's some fantastic interviews with Abel Ferrara and Willem Dafoe discussing the process of an actor and director working together. That documentary is called Sport and Life. And it's well worth checking out if you're a fan of Ferrara's work, because it really goes through his creative process. And more importantly, his creative process at the moment, working with an actor of Willem Dafoe's caliber, and them two discussing how they work together.
My job, then I gotta make sure I don't fuck up.
I love it when I participate in helping make the frame. I love it when I play with the camera.
So Siberia, by Abel Ferrara, another fantastic movie to the canon of work of, I think, one of the best filmmakers working today, Abel Ferrara.